Hi, I'm Chris from Geosoft, and in this video we'll walk through how to set up your project to run an inversion and oasis montage using Voxi. The steps in this video include loading the Voxi menu, setting up a new Voxi session, and adjusting the parameters to run an inversion. After watching this video, we recommend watching our other videos on running inversions. These include running an unconstrained inversion, an inversion with an upper bound constraint, followed by an inversion with gradient weight constraints. Data used in this video is from the open source Reid Mahaffey data from the Ontario Geological Survey, flown at 200 meters nominal line spacing and 60 meters terrain clearance. Before we can run an inversion, we need some input files which I've already prepared. We begin with a digital elevation model covering the area of interest to define the surface topography. Alternatively, you can also use a constant value representing the average elevation above the standard datum. Next, we'll need to create an outline defining the area of interest we want to model. Here we'll use a polygon to outline the area. The other option is to use a geolocated voxel compiled from other sources. Finally, we have a database containing observation coordinates along with potential field measurements. A coordinate system must be defined for the database. These requirements are well documented in the Preparing Your Data Best Practice Guide, found in the Oasis Montage Technical Documentation section of the Geosoft website. Before we can run an inversion, we'll need to first load the Voxi Inversion menu. To load the Voxi menu, click the Load menu shortcut from the Standards shortcut toolbar. The Load menu dialog is displayed. Scroll down to the list and select Voxi and click Open. Voxi Inversion is now displayed as a menu item in the Oasis Montage menu bar. We are now ready to create a new Voxi session from the input files we have prepared in order to run an inversion. From the Oasis Montage menu bar, click Voxi Inversion and select New Voxi from Polygon. The New Voxi from Polygon dialog is displayed. This dialog collects the location and resolution information. It also prompts you to define the session name, polygon file that defines the area of interest, and the digital elevation model grid file. We will enter our Voxi session name and select the polygon file we want to use. We will then select our DEM grid file. If our selected polygon file does not have a coordinate system defined, the Define button becomes active. We can also click the Create Polygon button to interactively create a new polygon to define our area of interest from an existing map. We are deciding to keep the model resolution at 50 meters, as this is roughly equivalent to the flying altitude and a quarter of the line spacing of the data we're using. At any point, you can click the question mark icon on the title bar to see all the various dialog options. Ensure that the information and input files that you have supplied are accurate. Now click OK. The Voxi Viewer opens your session along with a 3D illustration displaying the mesh resolution, the digital elevation model, and the outlined area of interest. The 3D view of the constructed model provides the opportunity to visually inspect the model. If it is not properly defined, for example, if the mesh is too coarse or too fine, if the terrain does not register correctly, or the area of interest polygon is not the right one, we can modify the model before we add more data and proceed with modeling. It also prompts you to add measurement data to the session. If you are not satisfied with the model and you'd like to modify any of these settings, click No. We will click No for now so we can inspect the model before starting to add measurement data. You can inspect the area of interest settings by expanding the area of interest in the tree viewer. You can modify any of the specified settings for the mesh and the digital elevation model. Right-click the mesh item under Area of Interest and select Modify. The Modify Mesh Parameters dialog is displayed. Here, you can modify the active volume cell size that affect the model resolution. Click More for further mesh parameters that you can modify for the model. Again, at any point, you can click the question mark icon on the title bar to see all the available dialog options. If you are satisfied with the parameters, click OK. Similarly, you can also modify the DEM grid. Right-click the DEM item under the area of interest and select Modify. The modified DEM grid is displayed. You can modify the DEM type and also supply an alternate DEM grid should you choose to do so. If you're satisfied with the parameters, click OK. We have now set up all the parameters to run our inversion.
This concludes our video on setting up your inversion project. Next, we recommend watching our video on running an unconstrained inversion, followed by the video on upper bound constraint inversions, and then the video on gradient weight constrained inversions. Thank you for watching.